This program example is a text-based chat where different chat clients can have a conversation with each other. So it will illustrate how a text-based protocol can be designed, and it also shows an appropriate architecture including threading on both client and server side. First, I will explain how it works. First, there is the chat server to which all clients will be connected. Then there is a number of chat clients communicating with each other. Clients are connected to the server, so all clients also have a user interface, of course. This is supposed to be a screen. Okay, the user interface also consists of a keyboard, of course. This is a keyboard. So let's say that a user wants to send a message, so the user types on the keyboard. The data is entered in the client program and transmitted to the server. And then the server broadcasts the message to all clients, including the one that sent the message. And all clients will show the message on the screen. That is how it goes. That's basically the only thing that can be done with the program. Well, there are a few other things. First, connection must be established, so there's need for connect command. So, but this connect command, of course, only exists between keyboard and the client side. There's no sending a connect command from the client to the server. All that happens when the client connects to the server is that the TCP connection is established. Then there is also the command sending a message, which is called entry. So this is a command named enter that is sent from client, the sending client, to the server. The entry command is this red message here. Then there's the broadcast command, which is the black messages, and the disconnect command, which means to disconnect from the server. Close the connection. Then there is also the user command, which client uses to specify its nickname. When the messages are broadcast, as in the black arrows here, the user's nickname is included. So the message will say that user Alice sent the message. Then on all clients, the message on the screen will appear as Alice. And then this message. Therefore, it must also be possible to define the nickname of each client. And when a new client connects, let's say there is a new client connecting here to the server. First, the new client has no username, so if a message is entered here, it will appear as anonymous, and then the message. But then maybe this new client defines a username, let's say Bob. Then all the clients will see that Bob joined the conversation. This message will be broadcasted to all clients. Then maybe Bob sends some message ABC. So then all clients will see Bob ABC. Bob says ABC. Maybe eventually Bob quits. Then the server will broadcast the message Bob left conversation. Okay, that's basically how it works. So then let's look at the text-based protocol in more detail. So it's here in the common package, because the common package contains things that are used at both client and server side. So the MSG type contains the constants for the protocol. There are four different types of messages. User message is used to specify the username of a particular client. Entry means that the client sends a new message in the conversation. And broadcast is when the new message sent from client to server in entry is broadcasted to all clients. So entry goes from client to server, a new message, and broadcast follows from server to all clients. And disconnect means that a client is leaving the conversation. The format of a message is that first the message type is sent, for example user, say that this is a user message. Then there is a double hash sign, and then follows the message body, in this case the username, for example Alice. Now let's have a look at the architecture, what packages there are. The text protocol chat is in these packages. First, there is typical client-side architecture, MVC layered architecture. There is the view layer, the controller layer, and the net layer. So there is no model on the client side. There is no permanent representation of anything. The client is completely stateless. And on the server, there are these packages. There is the net package, the controller, and the model. So on the server side, there is a model because there is a state, and the state is the entire conversation. So that is what is kept in the model. And when a new client joins the conversation, that client will get the entire conversation that has been performed up to the point where the new client joined. So that is to have an example of a state on the server side. Quite small model, contains just the conversation. And the controller is also quite small, just has methods to add entries in the conversation and retrieve the conversation. We could say it's a bit overkill with controller and model for such a small model, such a small state. But that is to give an example of a stateful server. Also interesting here is that on the server side, on the top we have a net package, not a view package, because the entry point to the server is the network. On the client side, on the other hand, the view stays on the top. Events originate in the view. This cloud can symbolize the net. Network communication is done between the network layers, of course. On the server side, the flow is quite straightforward. It's from the top and downwards. Events originate in the net layer and then proceeds down through controller to model. If there are return values, they are returned upwards the same way. On the client side, events originate in the view when the user does something, proceeds through controller to net and out to the server. But then there are also events that originate in the net. When the server sends a message to the client, the event starts in the net layer and then proceeds upwards to the view where they are shown to the user. So this yellow thing is a bit awkward. We didn't really want up calls this way. Of course, I mean, we could have them. Might not be a disaster, but it's much more flexible and more easy maintained program if there are no such up calls as the yellow line. And that's where the observer pattern enters. So this video will also illustrate how the observer pattern is used. Basically, there is an interface in the net layer. This is an interface that is implemented by a class in the view. So the yellow line will not really go this way, but instead will go to the component specified by the interface, an object of the class implementing the interface. So it in a sense will stay in the net layer and then go from the implementing class to the user. So there is no up call through the controller, and we'll see how this works. So finally, there is also the common package that includes things common for both client and server. And that is the message type that we already saw, where the messages are defined. Constants that contain some constants. The message delimiter between the type and the body was the double hash. And before the delimiter at index 0, we have the message type, and after the delimiter at index 1, that is, we have the message body. And then there's also a message exception used for communication problems.